Edition of Spectrum Wrestling, featuring Sergeant Slaughter and Magnificent Morocco in a tag team match against Andre the Giant and Jimmy Superfly Snuka. And in the main event, Hulk Hogan makes his first Spectrum title defense against the Masked Superstar. It's the excitement of the World Wrestling Federation, and it's coming up next. So settle in and get comfortable for the next 2.5 hours as Prism presents Spectrum Wrestling.
Well, hello there, and the fans are going by our camera location.
I love it.
Grilla Monsoon, this is Dick Graham again on Prism Television, and wrestling again. Are you always ready for what's coming up? We got Hulk Hogan, the new champion tonight. Tag team matches.
Three big tag team matches.
Title defenses.
Three titles at stake tonight.
Tito Santana.
The new Intercontinental Champion.
All right.
Mr. Atlas and Rocky Johnson, the tag team champion.
Tag team.
Putting their belts on the line tonight against Morocco and Piper.
Woo! Can you stand it? I mean, really, are you ready?
Roddy Piper, believe it or not.
He's Mr. Nasty Head. Well, I'll tell you what. We're about ready to get underway, so let's get that camera on the ring because we're just about ready to start event number one. And it will be...
Rene Goulet.
And the crowd is cranked up and turned on and ready to go. Goulet, of course, in his cape. And we're waiting for his opponent showing up here in just a moment or two.
Brian Blair, an outstanding newcomer, Dick, with a lot of credentials and a lot of talent. You're going to really like this boy.
Well, what do we have here, Gorilla Monsoon? You've got the old pro, and I don't mean old in years, but I mean the guy's been around. He knows all the holds
the
and
veteran.
All the... He is a veteran. Now, what's the new guy going to have to do?
Well, he's going to have to show him that he is ready to step up into the top ranks because that's what Goulet is, a top contender. And Brian Blair can make a reputation for himself here tonight in the Spectrum, if nothing more.
Well, let's find out if he can. Go to Mel Phillips. Let's hear the introductions.
Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Mel Phillips. And from the world's greatest showplace, the Philadelphia Spectrum, welcome to another action-filled all-star card of championship wrestling. These matches are presented by the World Wrestling Federation, and they are supervised and sanctioned by the Pennsylvania State Athletic Commission. The Honorable James J. Vince, Chairman, Francis Walker, the Executive Director. The officials in attendance at ringside are Chief Deputy Commissioner in Charge, John Stewart, attending physician, Dr. Wallace Davidson, timekeeper at the bell, Jimmy Mina, the referees assigned by the State Athletic Commission, Dusty Feldbaumer, Joe Morella, Dick Worley, for the opening contest, Ray Malazecki. The opening contest is scheduled for one fall with a 20-minute time limit. Introducing first from Nice, France, weighing 237 pounds, the Claw Master, Rene Goulet. Opponent from Tampa, Florida, weighing 235 pounds, B. Brian Blair.
All right, fans respond to the introductions, and I'm telling you, the place is bulging at the seams. Spectrum, I don't know if there's any room in here for any more fans, but anyway, those who could get in and have seats are here, and they're ready for the action. As Gorilla Monsoon and I were saying at the top of our telecast, we have a big lineup tonight. Talking to Tony Atlas earlier tonight, Rocky Johnson, they're ready because they're defending their belt against Don Morocco and Rowdy Roddy Piper. Tito Santana's here, the Iron Sheik, Mr. Fuji, Tiger Chung Lee, Eddie Gilbert, Tony Garea, Andre the Giant, Jimmy Superfly Snuka, and we have them all, of course, Salvatore Palomo, Butcher Paul Vachon, Max Superstar, and the new champion, who else but Hulkamania, setting in Hulk Hogan.
Brian Blair, Got a nice reception here, Dick. Television wrestling fans certainly know who he is. He's been on for several weeks now, and they can appreciate good talent when they see it.
Well, he's carrying, what, about 240 pounds, 230, 235 maybe?
Right around that area.
Yeah. So... Gervais kind of complaining to the referee about a hair pull, but, well, maybe, maybe not. Side headlock by Gervais on Blair.
Highly unlikely.
Yeah.
Nice maneuver there by Blair. Rene snaps him right over.
Nice thing about that, a young guy gets the veteran's attention by, well, not a real pin, but he had the shoulders down.
In a hurry.
In a hurry for sure.
Yeah. Interesting to see if Rene will go after the very heavily bandaged right hand of Brian Blair. I understand he was in an automobile accident and had to be stitched up quite badly in that right hand, but I guess the doctors saw fit to let him go ahead here.
Seems to be all right.
And guys like Rene look for things like that, Dick. Things that if you're walking there with a piece of tape, if you got a bad right shoulder, you better tape up the left one.
That's right.
Because you're going to go to work on it.
Well, looks like a couple of fingers are scotch taped together, too, on the right hand of Blair. Anyway, looks like he's ready to wrestle anyway. Nice takedown by Goulet. Hey, slipping behind him now is Blair.
Showing us some nice wrestling moves now.
Well, let's face it, the younger guys have that quickness, not to say some of the veterans don't. Brian Blair shows us some speed and agility.
It's the most convenient way to break a hold. Rene went right over to the rope, stuck his arm on there. You know, the old veteran.
Well, the fans not buying this too much. They like to see a guy bailing out, and he did. And Brian Blair says, hey, come on, let's get him back in here. I want him. There's the eagerness of youth.
Grandma got better body than that.
To be too eager with a guy like Rene. Nice finals carry. Beautifully done.
Fans loving that maneuver, too. But Delay, you know, he paces himself. He's not going to spend it all in the first couple of minutes.
Well, he won't run out of gas on you.
Nope. He really doesn't.
Stays in good shape.
Oh, nice kick. Now we've got a little leverage going here with Delay against Brian Blair.
Beautiful. Right over the top.
Drag takedown, and Brian Blair in control of the present time. Still working on that left shoulder and that arm area of Rene Goulet. Jam-packed this Spectrum crowd tonight, as usual.
Hanging from the rafters.
They sure are. This place has really seen a crowd, the Flyers in the afternoon, wrestling at night. Boy, more events than you can really count coming up here.
I understand they were victorious, too, this afternoon.
Yep, 4-3, I believe.
Brian now still working on the left arm of Rene, trying to put some pressure on that upper arm shoulder area. Rene now backs him in, sends him for the ride.
Oh!
Nice shoulder block as down goes. Rene dropped one. Nice and close. Nice arm drag over the top.
He was ready, and Goulet, of course, wasn't. Goulet expected Blair to keep on going, get some leverage off the other side of the ring, off the rope. But instead, he stood there waiting for Goulet to turn around, nail him with an arm drag. This guy's know a few holes, doesn't he? Huh?
Yes, he does. No question. He's a, you know, just to watch him in the ring and see the way he's maneuvering himself and positioning himself and how he's continually going back to that beautiful arm drag series that he's using shows me a lot. There it is again. You know, you find a spot, you go to work on it, and you stay with it. Sometimes the young guys want the results right immediately, now, quick, and it doesn't work that way, though. Got to work on some part of the body, try to wear the guy down, and especially a guy like Goulet, who been in that ring some 15, 16 years, knows his way around very well, and you better not make a mistake or the lights will go out in a hurry.
That's for sure. It'll be good night. And, of course, these guys use the ropes, too. A lot of the fans don't like it, but sometimes a guy will just place one leg throughout the bottom rope going outside the ring, and that breaks off the action. They don't like it, but here's a little hair pull. Hair pull again. Referee breaking it up. Still a hair pull. Give it a count of one, two.
Well, What is he counting him for? What's he going to do to him? Bryan has the controlling hold. What's he going to do? Make Renee break the hold?
Hardly.
You know, that's one advantage. Renee takes advantage of that situation. He's the one that's on the defensive. So he maneuvers around and pulls himself some hair. What's the referee going to do about it? Absolutely nothing.
That's right.
All right. Delay. Got a handful of tights.
Oh! Knee to the groin area.
Whoa!
Delay. Fans are loving it.
Fans, by the way, still pouring into the Spectrum. Must be a few seats left. I don't know where or how, but they got them.
I don't know where they are, Dick. I don't see any. Of course, I've never been accused of having 20/20 vision either, Dick.
I've seen you squint a few times.
Oh, my God.
Me too.
Renee taking some vicious punishment now. Got to be getting sore, no question. Reaching up in the face area, that'll break the hold in a hurry if he gets up in your eyes.
Well, Delay grabbing from some of the flesh around the waist. Now
he's looking for some loose flesh, and there isn't any there.
Not on this guy. Bryan Blair is pretty well set up. No fat at all.
Oh, he
went for the eyes. Well, here's a knee lift. He's just got a juggling the head a little bit while he's kind of babying that left shoulder. He's finding a little sting there somewhere.
He's getting four knuckles right between the eyes. Looking for approval now from the fans, which of course he's not going to get.
Oh, slamming into the turnbuckle.
If that doesn't clear your head, I don't know what will mess it up.
What you have to remember, fans, is you got a guy like Delay. He's got a bag of tricks that won't quit. So while you think he's doing one thing, he may be thinking something else. He can take you different ways.
Oh, he's thinking 3-4 moves ahead all the time. Hard for a youngster, an upcomer like Bryan to be able to do that. I'm sure he's thinking ahead, but whether thinking with the consistency that a Goulet can think with, I doubt it at this point. Nice one.
Oh! Coming into the... Oh, reversal! Nice touchdown by Bryan Blair. There's that arm drag again. Still working on that left arm and shoulder of Ray Goulet, and also adding the knee pressure to the head. Help keep him down.
If you said earlier the calling attention to Bryan Blair's right hand and the fingers to an injury, if they're bothering him a heck of a lot, I'm not seeing it.
No, I'm not either. Bryan's still after that left arm, and rightly so. That's been working on that for some 5-6 minutes now, maybe longer. It's the wear down his war horse. Doctor just making his appearance here at ringside after checking all the contestants for this evening.
Yeah, I saw Rocky Johnson, some of the guys getting the blood test, getting checked over earlier tonight by the doctor.
Oh, nice maneuver by Goulet.
I don't know. He's got a lot of weight on the upper body area of Blair, but apparently not good enough for a pin. He's trying, but
Blair's going to bridge right out of this.
Yeah, he can. There he goes. You must have called it.
Oh, nice.
Very
beautiful maneuver. Nice hip roll. Down goes Goulet, and there's that arm drag again.
Well, the guys, I'll tell you, he's winning the fans over real fast here at the Spectrum.
All right, bring that knee and all his body weight down on the shoulder of Ray Goulet. But what's the call? Timeout, but there is no timeout.
Bryan really applying some heavy pressure now on that shoulder. Renee in obvious pain, wishing he were somewhere else,
for sure.
Look how he maneuvers him right back into the corner here. Referee's got to break it now.
Got a two and a count of three, and off. Whoa! Not quite off the ropes. Knee to midsection, slam to the neck on Bryan Blair. You can hear that all over the Spectrum. One, a two, and a kick out.
Reverse chin lock here. Marshall sleeper, I believe. Now he doesn't have it hooked around the backside. This could turn into a choke very easily. Player's body's vibrating a little bit. He's another grab hold. He can grab hair, which he hasn't done really, but no way he can pull on the head of Rene Goulet.
Well, he's got to hook that arm that can turn in. That's a weak arm. That's the one he's been working on all this time.
Yeah.
He's got to hook it with his own left arm and just turn it into a hammerlock here, and he'll be back in control.
Well, referee very carefully checking, make sure there's no choking going on. It's apparently not. But you can't prove that to Brian Blair right now. He's in deep trouble. Just trying to kick out, unsuccessful. Maybe trying to get to his feet where maybe he can start to deal a little bit.
He's got to come to his feet.
Yeah.
Alleviate some of the downward pressure.
And he can maneuver a little bit. Now, maybe. Well, give the guy credit. Hey! Oh, shoulder block. Down goes Goulet. Joe Rowe thought he cut a shoulder block again. Got a knee right in the midsection. Down he goes. Goulet bringing toward us. Outside the ring. Here our broadcast location.
Rene right going up to the top rope.
Hey, he's going to break your ankle.
Well, if he waits too long, it's going to be too late.
Already too late, Dick.
Yep. He thought about it. The referee warned him. This guy, Blair, has a Bob Backlund type of build, if you want to.
Yes, he does.
Oh, kick our way down on the Spectrum floor. That's a hard floor, by the way, fans. You're looking at
nothing down there but ice. Underneath that,
that's right.
Brian Blair is beginning to get an education as to what it's all about when you go in there. All right, pick something up off the ring apron now that someone threw in the ring. You know he's going to use it.
Oh, he's going for the nose.
Woo. Something in his hand, eh?
Or any, I don't know whether he went, there's a back to us. I don't know whether he went for the eye or the nose. I think he went for the eyes. Can't see. Brian Blair really cannot see. Count of one or two there. All right, Goulet brings it back into the ring again. And Blair trying to retaliate. Kick to the midsection. Kick to the midsection again. Another one. Goulet bent over. And Blair trying to recover. Woo!
Can't wait too long. Rene's ready.
Hey, had his back toward it. Down he goes on one knee.
Are you okay?
He's biting him.
Kiss him.
Oh, man. Well, we've seen him do that before.
That should be an automatic disqualification.
It really should be. Blair really in pain. Went for the ear. And that's smarts, man. And that's saying even a little bit of it. Really smarts.
Referee admonishing him, pointing the finger at him. He just ought to go over and ring the bell.
Well, looks like Blair's half out of the under the ropes there, so they got a break.
What are you fighting now?
Goulet not backing off, though. They broke. Anything, Goulet's got to make sure he gets back in the ring, and he is now. There's a forearm smash to the jaw. But Blair retaliates.
Desperation move, but he got it in there.
Yes, he did.
Slowed Rene down. Rene back with a claw. This could be it.
This might be. He's got the claw on the forehead. And there's pressure like you never felt before. Ringside camera close up on the action there. The left foot of Goulet and the upper body of Blair on the other side. He's maintaining that pressure. Woo. There, the crowd really came alive fast tonight. Fast and furious action. Rene Goulet and newcomer Brian Blair.
Well, they're ready.
There's a count of two.
They're ready.
They sure are. They got to be ready. We've got a program that won't stop tonight. All the way up to the championship with Hulk Hogan.
One particular match I'm looking forward to, Dick, is that Andre the Giant and Superfly Jimmy Snuka taking on Dr. D. Schultz and Sergeant Slaughter. What a combo. Holy mackerel.
Well, Sergeant Slaughter had something going recently against the Iron Sheik, the way of changing fans around, but...
Well, he hates the Sheik with a passion.
Oh, yes, he does. Well...
But there's no love there for Andre or Snuka either. You
that's
that
true.
On Rene maintaining control now with a claw hold.
He is. He's keeping the pressure on Brian Blair.
friend of ours, Joey Glorioso, his mom and dad in attendance tonight. Little Joey coming back from a few physical problems. He's glad to be here, and he got Hulk Hogan's autograph, so he's away happy tonight.
Fans trying to get things going here for Brian Blair, trying to give him that little extra something. Brian's got that leg going now.
All right. Still maintaining the pressure. Oh! Blair's
coming up.
Woo! Doing a little knee, Bill Buckaloo here. Oh, Buckaloo body slam. Oh, he got the strength, but he got it. He's coming back. Shoulder blocking. Both of them down. They hit it. They collided. Both heads collided. There's a count of three, four, count of five over both these guys. Delay on his knees. Count of seven, maybe.
Count stops once you reach your knees.
All right. Oh! Now here's a brawl, man. There's a body slam by Goulet.
Goulet coming outside. He's going to flip that turnbuckle.
If he can. He's wobbly, though, I'll tell you.
He's tired.
He is tired. Oh! Look out! Woo! Oh!
Beautiful slam off the top turnbuckle by B. Brian Blair.
Back. Coming our way. Back body drop. Blair better go for it. Keep that pressure on. Whoa!
Dropped that elbow right into the sternum, and that really took the starch out of Rene.
Well, that was a temptation of Brian Blair's part. He's going to make a soprano out of Goulet.
Whoa! Hey, there's a... You don't expect a young guy to do that one, huh?
No, sir.
No!
Abdominal stretch, one of his favorite holds. He could sit back with it here and look for a pin.
Goulet in trouble, but hasn't given up.
Referee right close to him. He says no. Give him credit. Goulet's not going to give in, at least for the moment.
Brian usually doesn't use this as a submission, Dick. He gets you worn down with it, and then he sits back and pins you with what we call a crucifix. Oh, Renee. Pulled that leg right up and got right out of there. Just in a nick of time, too, I think.
Well, Blair right on top of him, slowly but surely. Going to take him right back again to the abdominal stretch. Whoa! Time. So I think I heard a bell. Looks like the time expired on this.
Referee didn't hear the bell. He did.
The 20-minute time limit apparently expired. One fall 20. I will get the announcement here in just a moment from Bill Phillips. He's checking in with the referee. Here we go. Hey, the action's still on the other side of the ring. They're not giving up. So we'll have to wait for the announcement. Delayed down. Blair gone after him. And Relay out of the delay out of the ring.
I believe he's had enough now. Do you like pretzels at all, Dick?
Not too well. Not too well.
Not when they're thrown from the balcony.
Ladies and gentlemen, they have wrestled to the 20-minute time limit. The official decision on this contest is a draw.
Oh, Renee's coming back. This match may not be over yet.
Well, I think maybe it's the last shot, a little bit of fan reaction. No way, though.
Okay, you got... All right, let's check it out now. Here we have the events leading up to the draw. Just before, into the ropes, back again. Back body drop on delay by Blair, who turns immediately. And so it went. Fans coming to Prism in March, it's Eddie Murray in 48 hours. You're watching Spectrum Wrestling exclusively on Prism.
But I gave you 48 hours to come up with something, and the clock's running.
They couldn't like each other less. They couldn't need each other more.
You want to bet?
I'm looking for a good old boy by the name of Billy Bear.
Never heard of him. Heard of him now, man?
I'm the calm type. You come clean and we're going again right here, right now.
Nick Nolte, Eddie Murphy, in 48 hours.
All right, fans, getting ready for more action here. And by the way, you might be interested in a little bit of a run on videotape. Here's some of the crowd. This was earlier, not too much earlier tonight. And there they are, some of the fans waiting access to the young guy I know, waving his hand. He's at ringside tonight. So they're all waiting to get in here at the Spectrum. That's earlier tonight when they opened the gates around 7 o'clock. And I'll tell you, they poured in. So a bunch of happy fans anticipating action tonight. Their anticipation is well deserved because they're getting it. So let's go to match number two.
Ladies and gentlemen, this next contest is also scheduled for one fall with a 20-minute time limit. First, introducing from Brooklyn, New York, weighing in at 236 pounds, Steve Lombardi. His opponent from Puerto Rico, weighing 241 pounds, Jose Luis Rivera.
The wrestler getting a big hand here, Dick. I'm very surprised. Jose Luis, since his return to the World Wrestling Federation, doing very well for himself. We have a lot of Spanish-speaking folks here tonight in the Spectrum.
For sure.
And, maybe they're not too happy with Luis.
Well, it's funny. Maybe they...
Whatever turns you on, right?
Well, sometimes the fans pick up something during previous wrestling events with a certain guy, and maybe he bails out when they think he ought to have been more aggressive. Who knows why they get on his case?
Could be.
Well, okay. Action right off the bat, although they got a break off the Dusty Feldbarmer, calling action to a halt there while they get off the ropes. And Lombardi in from New York, mixing up with a guy with a little more experience, but looks to be very willing, Lombardi. All right, clean break again, huh?
Well, newcomer coming down the road some 6 or 8 months as a professional wrestler, trying to make a name for himself.
Right side headlock by Jose Luis Rivera. Rivera looking pretty good tonight, prim, as usual. Lombardi just a little bit shorter, stocky. Still maintain pressure on the side of the head is Rivera. Cranking up, I call it. He's cranking up a little. Takes him down, cranks up again. Bends that neck a little bit. And a lot of the fans, I think, don't realize quite... whoa, shoulder block. Down goes Lombardi. He says, oh, wow, where'd that come from? Side headlock. Right back where they were. But the vertebrae really takes the beating, and who would know better than you about that?
The vertebrae do take a beating.
They sure do. And,
well, one of the worst injuries I ever had. 3 cervical vertebrae twisted around 90 degrees in my back. Knocked me out of the box for almost 8 months. Occupational hazard.
Yeah, well, you look at it realistically, although it doesn't help you while it's happening to you. No, I think a lot of fans miss the point that these bodies really take a heck of a beating.
Oh, every night. And the worst of it is that most times you have to go in there with the injury.
Yeah. Well, Brian Blair just a little while ago with a hand injury. Right. Eddie Gilbert not too very long ago coming off that auto injury.
Now, what are you going to do? You can't come up here and announce Andre the Giant won't appear tonight. He has a sprained ankle.
All right. Or has a bad headache. No way.
Riot on Broad Street.
All right. There's a nice takedown by Rivera. As we've seen many times before, this is a young Steve Lombardi. As we've seen with other young wrestlers coming along the circuit, there he's getting a wrestling lesson tonight. Rivera still maintaining the pressure, side headlock, and now back on their knees and knee, respectively. No pressure added, Rivera. Now they're both back on their feet. Rivera with a little bit of a height advantage, if that isn't an advantage at all, really.
It certainly is in a side headlock.
Yeah. All right. Into the ropes, off the ropes, shoulder block, down Lombardi. Rivera getting, grabbed him down again.
That's Lombardi. A sign of a novice, Dick. Steve had no idea where Jose was in the ring.
That's right.
Had no idea where he was in the ring. Consequently, turned around and got caught right back in that same side headlock again.
Many times you see a guy coming off a rope and stop, and the other guy thinks that's his back to him, thinks he's going off the other ropes to gain leverage, and there he is, does a drop kick or whatever. It's always a surprise. You got to keep you have to keep moving at all times, all the action. You can't turn your back for a second. Dusty Fellbaumer, the third man in the squared circle, keeping things under control here, checking things. Nothing really to check here. There's no threat of a choke or anything, but he's checking. He keeps on top. Dick Worley telling me tonight he has a surprise for you and me and all the wrestling fans when he comes in the ring for the first time tonight. Won't tell me what it is.
Dick, there isn't anything that Dick Worley could do that would surprise me. Believe
all right.
Me. I've known him for a long time.
He says, you and Monsoon, Graham, are going to
get you. Oh, my God, I can't wait.
Well, I don't know what it is, but he said to look out tonight.
He'll probably want to come over here and trade places with us.
I'm not going in the ring with those guys. Art Lombardi is outside the ring right now. Rivera kind of wanting at him, but Fellbaumer says, hey, back off. Give the guy some room to get in. But I noticed that Lombardi's favoring the small of his back a little bit. Fans kind of saying, hey, come on, let's get back in, Lombardi. Let's get it on. Lombardi buying maybe a little more time, warning Rivera a back. He really has enough time to get back in if he wants. Nobody's going to.
Now, it's a question. He might have came in here cold, Dick.
Might have.
A lot of the guys, the super fly and the veterans, know that they must break a sweat before they come out here to eliminate just particularly that type injury.
Right.
You come in this ring cold and you start getting slammed and banged around out there in the first two or three minutes, and you're going to be in for a long night, and you're going to end up with some physical injuries.
All right. Only about a year or so back, Gorilla Monsoon was still active. What did you do preparing for a night at the Spectrum?
Oh, definitely break a sweat. The free exercise, push-ups, run up and down the back corridors here at the Spectrum.
Okay.
Use a piece of surgical tubing, which you can get an awful lot out of in a hurry. And in general, if I can get somebody to tie up with me and just move around and
just weight against weight.
Oh, you got to do it.
Okay.
Just like the football players warm up before their events, the hockey guys whack each other around. Got to get ready.
Well, I told the story many times over, coming down early one night to the Spectrum, and hardly anybody was here, and I happened to glance up the top deck, and here was Backlund running up and down the steps, down the steps, got his wheels, his legs in shape.
Does that all the time.
Yeah. And he was a great believer in the one wheel, the wheel with the two handles, working out on that to build up the... fans getting on the case of the two guys in the ring. Well, Rivera still giving it pretty good to Lombardi. The fans can get on the guy's case a little bit, but he's the guy taking the action.
Absolutely.
You know what's going through Lombardi's mind? I mean, he's favoring the small of his back. Fellbaumer warning Rivera away. Now they can get back in it again. You could be right about Lombardi not totally warmed up. It looks like he's just a little bit out of breath. I don't mean out of shape, just a little bit out of breath.
Standing wrist lock.
Oh, all right. Lombardi with a side headlock now on Rivera. Now it's a turnabout, huh? Oh, battle of strength. There's a hair pull. Pulling Rivera around, facing same way he's going. The side headlock in effect again. He's cranking up again.
Cranking up.
Going out the ropes now. Oh, back by
big
top.
Woo!
If his back hurt before, man, he knows he's in trouble now. All right, Rivera with a side headlock. Still maintaining that pressure on the side of Lombardi. Kick to the midsection, take him into the other corner, and Lombardi's still hurting with that small of his back, taking another beating. Oh, reverses! Oh, beautiful!
High cross body, he's going to get him. He's got the leg hook.
He got him! All right! Beautiful maneuver by Jose Luis Rivera. Beautiful. The fans love that. Turn them on, didn't it, huh? Lombardi says,
he's hurt.
He got a twin. Where'd that guy come from?
He's hurt.
He is hurt.
Yes, no question about it. Let's get the official time.
Time of the fall, 7 minutes, 14 seconds. The winner, Jose Luis Rivera.
Lombardi went out of here limping, Dick. He's hurt. He's got a lower back injury of some kind. And Rivera just flips over the top rope. On his way to the dressing room.
Let's check the action here. Here we go into the corner. Now, Lombardi comes out again. Rivera going for him. He's going to take him into the corner. It looked like a reversal.
Nice reversal here, but Mack was too smart for him. He came right off that second turnbuckle. Right. Look at the leg
up. Right.
He knew he had him.
He had him. One quick movement. Well, fans, we'll be right back with more wrestling, but first, here's some scenes from a movie coming up on Prism in March.
Dorothy, in the first place, I want you to know that what happened last night was the most beautiful, wonderful, crazy thing that's ever happened to me, and I'll never forget it. Or you.
Doris.
We shared things. My God, I helped deliver your child, remember?
I consider that our finest hour. Have we changed much?
Oh, sure we have. I grew up with you.
Same time, next year.
All right, Gorilla Monsoon, yours truly, Dick Graham here, ringside. Spectrum action going to continue in a moment. And Hulkamania signs are appearing
everywhere.
Yep, and well-founded, too, because this guy, in fact, I said hi to him a little while ago before we came on the air, and he said it's been about 3 years since I last saw him. I thought it was about a year.
Well, there's Dick Worley.
Yeah. All right. Here it is. He said, I've got new wrestling attire. Get a little
look at the grin.
Yeah, right.
Rowdy Roddy Piper.
All right.
Now making his way into the ring with the magnificent one, Morocco. Incidentally, minus his title, Dick.
I know. I noticed that. In fact, Tito Santana holds the belt. The Intercontinental belt, the championship, and that will be on the line tonight a little later on. Tell you more about that later.
Stripped it from him in the Boston Gardens.
Yep. All right, Superman t-shirt being worn by Rowdy Roddy and his kilt. And a rather quiet for the time being, Magnificent Morocco on board two.
Waiting the appearance of the World Tag Team Champions, Tony Atlas and Rocky Johnson. The dynamic duo.
What's going to be quite an evening here. We're just starting to warm up a little bit, believe it or not, as if we haven't been. Well, the fans starting to come alive because here they are, two popular superstars, super wrestlers, as they come into the ring.
Mr. USA, Tony Atlas.
Woo!
And Rocky Johnson. Let's go up to our ring announcer.
Wrestling fans, this next attraction is a special tag team event scheduled for one fall with a one-hour time limit. And it is for the World Tag Team Championship title. Introducing first the tag team combination consisting of from Sunset Beach, Hawaii, weighing 250 pounds, the Magnificent Morocco. D.C., weighing 250 pounds, the sensational Rocky Johnson. And his tag team partner from Roanoke, Virginia, weighing 252 pounds. Together, they are the current World Tag Team Champions. He has earned the title of Mr. USA.
About two great specimens, Dick.
Woo!
Do you think they spend any time in the gym, Dick?
Maybe a couple of minutes here and there, a couple of times a week.
A couple times a month.
I told Atlas one night, I said, Tony, if you ever wanted to start it, give me your body. I'll take it. And Johnson's no slouch. You talk about two guys in shape. Tony was working out, in a way, preparing for tonight's action. Up the hall a little while ago near the dressing room, boogalooing to some music. He had a portable radio on his shoulder.
And Michael Jackson going.
Yeah, sounded like it. Anyway.
These boys in the game together.
You can't take Morocco nor Piper lightly. Laugh if you want at the kilts. At Morocco if you want, but I'll tell you, Johnson and Atlas know their work's cut out for them.
Both fine wrestlers in their own right.
You bet.
He could play those bagpipes too, Dick.
Well, with my Scottish background, I wouldn't mind hearing it. Dick Worley, he has his hands cut, his work cut out, his hands full tonight.
Champions are not going to have an easy night here tonight in the Spectrum. Not by a long shot.
If they could possibly put eyes in the back of their head, they better do it, because these guys come at you from every angle. Dick Worley with a couple of preliminary comments. A little psych job here, Atlas and Piper going nose to nose. Underway. Woo! What is this?
Pandemonium broken loose here.
They are coming out of the park. Woo! All right. Woo-hoo! He's got him. Morocco. Piper down. Both of them. Both outside the ring. Woo!
The high five.
High five. You bet. Talk about this place jumping. Do you believe it? Don't you love it? Fans, don't you love it? Really? Morocco, Piper outside the ring talking it over. They're shocked. The two champions, Atlas and Rocky Johnson, also talking it over, but they're in good shape right now. Piper calling for timeout. Not going to get it.
Well, they better go back to the dressing room and get another game plan, Dick, because that one didn't work.
Piper gone off. I don't know. The fans are giving him a bad way to go. Morocco outside the ring on the apron.
Piper is hot.
He is hot, but you don't know what the world is thinking. He's upset.
Well, here's a little bit of your
so much for that.
I don't want any, thank you. Piper is a piece of work.
He really is.
All right. On our TV programs and has that Piper kick section, and he just cuts everybody to pieces.
Well, he's giving some advice to Don Morocco. The fans are on Morocco's case, and he can't stand it. They yell at Beach Bum at him. Boy, does that turn it? Woo! He's upset. He almost missed the rope with his foot. You talking about a guy turned on. And Atlas loving it because he's cool. Still yelling Beach Bum.
Is rocking now with Beach Bum. Fans are on their feet. Morocco and Piper already expended a great deal of energy, Dick.
They really have. That's a good point. I haven't really thought about it.
Oh, put the brakes on.
Patton says no way.
It's like pulling on a tree trunk.
He's cool. You talk about he's cool. Don't you love it? Don't you love it to death? Tony Atlas, he is cooler than cool. I don't want Morocco. I don't think he knows how to handle Atlas. He's not afraid, you know that for sure, but he doesn't know what to do. Well, he's made contact. Now he can figure out side headlock.
You got to respect the 24-inch arms.
You're darn right. Got to.
Nice drop down. Look out. outsmarted him for a second. Oh! Oh! Turned right around into that big high slam. Got a tag made in a rock over the top rope.
Oh!
Look out!
Rocky Johnson pulls him back. He wanted to tag Piper. Piper, no tag. Morocco's still in trouble.
Yeah.
Right onto the turnbuckle. The turnbuckle again, and Josh is not finished. He's just cranking up. Side headlock.
Marco would dearly love to get a little bit to his left, make the tag with Piper, and bail out a while.
Oh, he's got to. He's got too much trouble.
I don't know whether Josh's going to let him do it.
Well, he's going to try to keep away from that corner if at all possible, but it's the name of the game in tag team matches, and he gets in trouble. You get over and tag. I'm not too sure Piper's that anxious to get in there.
Oh, Piper!
Piper's doing a little sight job now on Tony Atlas.
Well, Piper, I'll tell you what happened in a second. Side, going after Rocky Johnson. Piper now. He came to our side of the ring and spit across the ring at Tony Atlas. That's what created all this. Johnson's on the short end. Pushing the head, the neck, if you will, of Rocky Johnson, Roddy Piper. He is Roddy, all right. And he's on the warpath. He's aggressive right now.
Great wrestler in his own right.
Rocky Johnson down. Piper taking a shot at Tony Atlas.
Managing several other wrestlers at the moment as well, Dave.
Yeah, that's quite a
Dr.
chore.
Dr. D. Schultz, who we'll see
who's
this evening.
Tonight, right?
And Mr. Wonderful, Paul Orndorff.
Well, he's going to do the head twist again, maybe. Our camera picking up all the action. Rocky Johnson being escorted by the fans.
Nice sneak maneuver there by Morocco.
Well, Dick Worley's back is turned. Morocco comes in, gives Johnson a shot. No pin.
Quick
There's a tag.
Look at how he's blocking. Stepped right in and blocked, made sure the Rock couldn't make it back
he's
to his
quick.
Corner.
Well, there's a lot at stake tonight. Morocco losing the Intercontinental belt recently, but now he and Piper standing a chance to pick up the tag team match title. Morocco going for the eyes on Johnson. Oh, right against the knee of Piper.
Exposed knee. Pulled down a...
Oh, a headbutt by Johnson against Piper.
Pulled down one of those knee pads, Dick, to let him do that.
Now he's getting a choke for the...
tag rope. He's got it around his neck. Referee once again distracted. As Morocco doing a nice job enticing Mr. Atlas into the ring so that referee Dick Worley can be distracted.
Well, there's the tag.
Really did a job on rocking the corner there for those 20 or 30 seconds.
That's all they needed. That's all they needed. Boy.
Tony Atlas hoping upon hope that Johnson can get over his corner, get the tag, and give Johnson a breather.
You know, body built and strength that has to go to the team of Johnson and Atlas, but gray matter has to go to the team of Morocco and Piper.
That's
no question
right.
in my mind.
Well, both nasty individuals, they came to wrestle. The tag made, Piper back in. He's going to start a number on Johnson, a knee lift. Now Johnson goes. Crawling over. He wants to tag on Tony Atlas. And there it is. Woo! Don't you love it?
Atlas, a house of fire, taking on both men now. Rocky Johnson back in, all four men in the ring.
Well, Dick Worley is a headbutt. Dick Worley just better back off.
Woo! Both men slung into each other. Rowdy Roddy outside the ring on the arena floor and a double team.
A
big double backdrop by Morocco.
Woo!
He's in a lot of trouble, Piper, now. Just
a double drop kick. Don't you love it, fans? I mean, don't you love it to death? Here we go.
Sunset flip by Tony Atlas. He's got him down in the corner. He got him.
All right.
Johnson and Tony Atlas successfully defending their title against a very formidable team. Holy macro pandemonium here in the Spectrum.
All right, it looks like Tony Atlas is hurt. He's limping off.
Had a bad hip and leg coming into this match, Nick.
Well,
let's get the official time.
Ladies and gentlemen, the time of the fall, 10 minutes, 3 seconds. Your winners and still World Tag Team Champions, the team.
He was raised in a centuries-old tradition. And arts. Preparing for a moment that would challenge even the wisest and most skilled of all his ancestors.
I'll be the last man standing when it's all over in that town in Texas.
Now, from the makers of Enter the Dragon, comes the big brawl.
Let's fight over here!
He don't fight right. He fights far.
Jackie Chan is going to the big brawl.
Cal Rudman standing by with Intercontinental Champion Tito Santana. Take it away, Cal.
Thank you, Dick Graham. Champ Tito Santana. The wrestling world is just dawning to the fact that you are the champion. It happened exactly 1 week ago, last Saturday, in the Boston Gardens. You defeated the magnificent Morocco. And we're going to talk about that. But before we do, we've got to deal with a problem that you have tonight. A rematch with the Iron Sheik. Just about a month ago, you were shooting for the championship of the World Wrestling Foundation. And now you're defending the Intercontinental Championship. But he has to take it from you. That puts a whole different color on this story, doesn't it?
That's right. You know, it's been a week that I've been a champion now, and it's a completely different outlook that I have going into this match. The Sheik cost me the World Championship title the last time I was here with him. You know, ever since I came to the Worldwide Wrestling Federation, my goal was to go after Don Morocco and take that Intercontinental belt. And all of a sudden, something else comes up. I have a chance at a world title match against the Sheik, who defeated Bob Backlund. And in the meantime, I had been training so hard, I was ready for the Sheik, you know. And the Sheik knows it. The last time I wrestled him here in Philadelphia,
he knew you were ready.
He knew I was ready, boy. I gave him everything and a little bit more that he can handle, and the fans were right there with me. There was no doubt in my mind.
Did you get suckered in with that chair? I mean, I couldn't believe that you put your hands on it, and that's what ended up costing you the chance to be the champ.
Well, a lot of things happen in the match that the referee does not understand because of different circumstances. The Sheik brought the chair into the ring, intended to use it on me. And finally, we took it away from him, and I was kind of struggling for the chair, and the Sheik came and hit me in the back and pushed me into the referee, and I ran into him, and the referee thought that I intentionally hit him. Therefore, it was a double disqualification, or I was disqualified. I think it was a double disqualification because the Sheik was disqualified for bringing it in, and then later on I became disqualified for hitting the referee with it too.
What do you have in store for the Sheik tonight? What tactics are we going to see?
Well, the only thing that I have in mind basically is to keep that title match. He's going after me now, and I have to be very careful because of the way he wrestles, the tactics he's going to use, anything. You know, he was the shortest-lived champion in the history of wrestling.
28 days.
28 days, to be exact. And now he's a little embarrassed. You know, he's from Iran and represents the Ayatollah or whoever. I'm not very familiar with his kind of people. And he wants to get that belt and take it back to Iran from America. And all I can say is, Sheik, you're going to have hell, brother, taking the belt here in Philadelphia from Tito Santana. I'm not going to say what I'm going to do and what I'm not going to do, but I'll tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to go in there and I'm going to give it 110% and keep that belt here in America.
Well, I wanted you to discuss the match, and we have a little bit of time. I don't even know if they have any tape of your defeating Magnificent Morocco. Will you give us an idea of just what you did to defeat him? I understand it's the toughest match you ever had in your career, and he almost had you a couple of times.
Well, I'm going to do a little explaining. The match was filmed, and from what I understand, I don't know if it was Morocco's or Albano's doing, but all of a sudden the film can't be found. And it was the toughest match that I've ever been involved in. And I had been practicing. I knew that if I was going to beat Morocco, I would have to do something that Morocco hadn't seen. And at one point of the match, I felt that Tito Santana had given it everything he had, and I was really down and hurt, and I thought, I'm not going to do it tonight. And then all of a sudden, the people were right there behind me, and they just made me. You know, I don't believe in going 110%, and the reason I say it now is because I think the people make you give it that extra. I always believed 100% is 100%, but the people made me grab that extra 10%, and Morocco had me down. He almost beat me a couple of times, and I could hear the people in the background just screaming. You know, they didn't want me to give up, and boy, all of a sudden, the thing that I've been practicing on, Morocco caught me with one of my flying elbows that he had been working on. And I know he probably figured that he could beat me if he could get me with it. But he didn't. It wasn't quite as effective as my elbow. And he went for it again, and I dropped down. And it was a perfect situation for me to use what I had been working for so long. I jumped up in the air, and Morocco went under me, and I hooked him with my ankles. And it was a combination, and it ended up a sunset flip. And Morocco didn't know what hit him. You know, it was that's what I had worked for. I said to myself, I got to catch him with something that Morocco hadn't seen before. And I took him over and I sunset flipped him, and it was 1, 2, 3, and I couldn't believe it, boy. The reason I knew that I had beat him was because of the response of people. The people in Boston were going crazy. They were going bananas, and I knew I'd become the Intercontinental Champion, and boy, it was the greatest feeling in the world.
Good luck to you, Tito Santana. We'll be right back.
They call him the Sheik.
Are you an Arab?
No, I'm Italian.
She's waiting for Mr. Wright.
Are you going out with him?
No, Christ.
He should be selling used cars.
You really expect me to get into a car with you?
I don't want you to call me. I've had nothing but trouble ever since I met you.
What do you think? You're too good for me?
It's the winning and losing we've all been through. Baby, it's you.
Well, fans, on your screen now, you see the events coming up. There's a double. That's
beautiful double drop kick. As down goes Magnificent One, and he's in trouble because Roddy, look at this shot.
He takes
sends Piper right back down the arena floor. Now look at a sunset flip here.
And here we go for the pin in a good spot there. And there we go. 1, 2, and 3, and it's all over. Well, you know, the action hasn't stopped, fans, because another title's on the line. We'll get to that in just a moment. Just a reminder, there's a young guy, Simon Whitfield, over in New Jersey, who needs blood. There's a blood drive on to help him. So transfusions are being taken each week at Burlington Masonic Temple, Route 541, Burlington, Mount Holly Road, February 21st. 5:30 to 9 p.m. Hope you can help, you Jersey wrestling fan.
Dick Simon is a big wrestling fan. He's here tonight in the Spectrum, and what a nice youngster, 6 years old. He needs his blood transfusions now, I understand, 3 or 4 times a week. It's a pretty heavy ordeal. I fell in love with the little guy, and I want to see these wrestling fans really open their hearts and get out and give some blood for a very, very worthy cause.
Okay, enough said.
Well, tell us something a little more about it later on. But right now, standing in the ring, the newly crowned Intercontinental Heavyweight Champion, Tito Santana, as he stripped the Magnificent One of his title in the Boston Gardens just days ago. And
well,
there he comes.
Here comes double trouble, maybe triple trouble. The guy from Iran.
The Iron Sheik.
Well,
wrestling fans, this next contest is scheduled for one fall with a 1 hour time limit, and it is for the Intercontinental Heavyweight Championship. Introducing first from Tehran, Iran, weighing 256 pounds, the former World Wrestling Federation champion, the Iron Sheik.
Yeah, we know he does a lot.
And ladies and gentlemen, from Tocula, Mexico, weighing 240 pounds, the newly crowned Intercontinental Heavyweight Champion, Tito Santana.
Crowd is on his feet. Many of them did not know that Tito Santana had won the title.
Thank you, buddy.
And they are really thrilled about
They are cranked up tonight, fans, I tell you. It's USA against Iran all the way. The American flags are being flown by probably half the crowd here tonight, and appropriate signs being held by the other folks. I'll tell you, the fans have definitely taken a stand here tonight. The Iron Sheik, I gotta give him credit for even walking into the ring, walking into the Spectrum. He's got nerve. So Santana with a new belt and the title which goes along with it. All right, referee Barella checking up the wrestling attire of the Iron Sheik. The Sheik recently. Coming on with a chant here against Iran, and more particular, the Iron Sheik. All right, okay.
You stinky balls here.
All right, Tito Santana wants to get it on, but the Sheik is upset. He's upset. Sympathy for me, and nor are the other fans here, the thousands of them at the Spectrum, but he gave us a punch on the mouth, and he's back out of the ring, and his main object is to go for the belt. However, he's distracted by the fans, so maybe that's a big plus for the new champion, Tito Santana.
Well, Tito was tough before. Now with that title, boy, you're going to have to really do a job on this guy.
He's got a lot of pride. The fans love him.
Give a cheap shot, Tito.
They ought to make his middle finger out of the way there.
I know.
You are red.
All right, nice go behind. Nice high takedown. Tito right out the back door. Woo! Iron Sheik, tremendous wrestler in his own right, Dick, represented his country, Iran, in the 1972 or 6, I'm not sure exactly, Olympics, was a medal winner. Very, very good, outstanding Greco-Roman style wrestler.
Well, his credentials are not to be questioned. However, his country of origin's got a, not helping him any.
Absolutely not. If I were him, the first thing I'd do is change my name.
That's right. Charlie Jones or something. He signed the ringside for Tito Santana.
All
right, Santana back to the corner by the sheet. Don't look for a clean break here. Oh! Santana broke out of it. Referee Morella just back him off. Say, hey, Pacito Santana, give him some room. You're not going to find anything fair about this match tonight. So far, it's been reasonably clean, but I wouldn't bet a nickel on it continuing. The fans getting on the Sheik's case. The ringside is really doing it to it. They're dumping some hostility on that guy. Side headlock by Santana. Lifted by the Sheik. Oh! Bring him right down on the knee. Sheik continuing.
Caught him with that atomic drop, and now he's going to work on that back area.
Here comes the gang with their shoes, and they probably weigh about 10 pounds each, I think. They look at it anyway. They're a weapon. Each of those feet are a weapon.
He almost stepped over him, Dick, to go for that cobra camel clutch of his. And he said, no, come on, get up. I want you on your feet.
Well, he wants to punish him.
You got an opportunity to go for the title. You take it whenever it comes.
You bet. He's going for the back now, Pacito Santana.
Pounding away on the kidney area.
He really is. There's down on both knees now.
Heavy.
There he's working on it back again.
Go back down low!
Santana, oh! Iron Sheik spinning down on Santana. There's a forearm to the back. One, whoa!
Small package coming up. He caught him in a small package and almost got it.
Almost had him. I think the back was bothering Santana, but that's not helping anymore.
Couldn't hold him down there, boy. Nice maneuver, quick.
Beautiful.
Very crafty by Tito, but just didn't have the strength to hold a big guy down. Suplex coming up.
Oh!
Oh, that'll knock your kidneys into the middle of next week.
Well, Santana really is battling for his life tonight. Forget the belt and the title. He's literally battling for survival. Santana down, not out, but he's hurt. The fans are trying to get him up.
Desperation right hand on another.
Santana caught for him.
Back you go.
Whoa. Taking him to the rope. Whoa.
Oh, for a backdrop, and as she caught him with a boot right under the chin.
And that boot, man, I'll tell you, is a weapon. The fans not buying it.
Santana going for the ride again.
Whoa!
Big high back. Oh, he come right down on that lower back area, that kidney area.
He really got it. And spinning down on it again. I'll tell you, this guy's, he's crazy. He's in bad territory here. The Iron Sheik. But the fans will have to tear him apart.
Putting those heavy boots in on the side and back and kidney area, Tito Santana, who's in a lot of trouble right now.
He really is. This is the last time he's going to be in bad trouble.
He went for another suplex, couldn't get him up. Tito's got the same position. Who did it?
Oh!
Tito got him up to the beauty, but that hurt Santana, Dick.
The trouble is Santana now is almost as, maybe as bad shape as the Iron Sheik.
That suplex has to be released at the exact precise moment. Tito did not do that. He got hurt just as much as the Sheik did on that.
He certainly did. Well, all right. Count of two, and that was it. Sheik trying to get it on. Santana still stunned. Oh, there's the midsection of Iron Sheik again by Santana. Santana with a knee lift, I'll tell you. Woo!
Got, Sheik going for the Boston Crab.
Santana fighting
to get him over. He's got him over. This could be it.
Morella, referee, should you give up?
Santana in a lot of pain.
Give up. I'll pay you good money to win.
Look at the pressure being applied here by the Sheik.
I don't know how he can take it.
Santana pushing on.
Beverly breaks the hold. The Boston Crab by the Iron Sheik. You see it, but you don't believe it. And I'll tell you, Santana could take a pounding.
Santana reached down for something. He's inside of a big right hand. Sends his cheek to the canvas.
Santana came with a right cross. He took that from Center City, Philadelphia, into South Philadelphia, boy. Woo! I mean, look out! Santana! Woo!
Thank you,
boy. Too late! Too late! No place to hide now!
Santana is hot and on fire!
Santana!
Sheik looking for mercy, looking for time.
Sheik, there's no place to hide. Drop kick by Santana. Oh, another one.
Power drive.
Take him into the rope.
Oh, airplane spin coming up. Got him up there. Sheik grabbed the hold of the rocket.
Well, we're going to look out with our camera crew. A ringside camera is speeding over there to pick up the action. Santana down. The Iron Sheik trying to get in the ring again. Santana pounding on the head of the Iron Sheik.
Referee Joe Morello's counted both of these guys out of the ring, Dick.
Too late. Woo!
Forearm shot over the top rope by Tito, but it's too late.
He's telling no contest.
I'm sure both men were counted out.
I think so. We'll take a moment or two. We'll get the official announcement by the ring announcer, Mel Phillips.
What an unbelievable bump over that top rope as both men went over there. One upside down. Tito Santana completely upside down. Let's get the official time.
The time of the fall, 9 minutes, 13 seconds. Both men were counted out of the ring. This contest is a draw.
Tito not happy about it, and he's hurting. That kidney area is really sore. Very pronounced limp now. He's going to need some attention.
Well, Santana, look. And our Sheik's not finished yet. He sees Santana's weak.
Pearl Harbored him.
He really did.
Santana now coming back, big right hand.
The Sheik
and
out of the
Sheik
ring.
Tails out. Sheik gone bananas here. Well, picked up a piece of iron pipe, used to ring the bell with.
I don't know, man. And nobody, they don't like him, but who's going to put him? Woo! The ring partially littered with a chair from ringside. Santana raising his arm. Though he didn't win, he considered himself the victor, and the crowd loving it. The crowd is loving it. All right, check your screen now. Santana badly hurt as he's going off. But here's the replay, going to the airplane spin.
Didn't quite get him up high enough, Dick. He left him down lower. He was able to reach that top. Look at Santana now, upside down, over that to the hard ice floor here at the Spectrum. Cal Rudman looking on in amazement as these two guys really battled it out.
Well, fans, we'll be right back with more exciting wrestling. But first, here's some scenes from a movie coming to Prism in March.
Any money in the writing racket?
Penny a word.
Write a million words, you'd be set.
He gave the world a new kind of American detective story.
Is this pure invention, or do you draw your material from life?
Real life.
He was a master of action.
Now there's a third body in the morgue you might be interested in.
Intrigue.
Not to ask whom.
And suspense. Created the Maltese Falcon, Sam Spade, and the Thin Man.
Who the hell are you now? Hammett the writer or Hammett the detective?
But he didn't write this mystery. he lived it. Frederick Forrest, Peter Boyle, and Mary Lou Henner.
It's not like in one of your stories, is it?
Never is like a story. Hammett.
Cal Rudman has some interesting interview guests, so let's go to the interview area.
Thank you, Dick Graham. Tiger Lee and Mr. Fuji up against the profile Pretty Boy twins, Tony Garea and Eddie Gilbert. Are you going after Eddie Gilbert's neck?
Look, boy son, we go for either opponent, Garea or Eddie Gilbert. Neck, leg, body, no mean no different to Mr. Fuji and Tiger Lee. Because we emphasize to public, to all American fans, when we in ring, we're in the ring to win, but also we're in the ring to torture. We make them scream like American pigs. We make them yell and beg. That's what we do. We don't just beat right away, one, two, three. We take time. We make them suffer. That's what we love to see, face suffer for pitiness and help. You understand?
Oh, I understand. Is that the way you feel about it?
He no talk nothing.
No talk?
He no say nothing. All he do is do what Mr. Fuji said, Lee, you go, you torture, you make him suffer. He look at Mr. Fuji, he said, very good, Mr. Fuji-san, because me, Fuji-san, Japanese, him Korean, Japanese, is captain. You understand?
I understand.
You understand? Very good, American boy.
Yes.
You very good announcer, very good mind. Now you understand, Gilbert? And you, Garea, you in big trouble tonight. I am very, very sorry for you two. Very, very sorry. Perhaps both go out crippled. I don't know. But perhaps, perhaps you don't see tomorrow. I'm very sorry, too.
How do you plan to counter their speed?
We don't plan nothing. We just use our ring psychology because I am the master of martial art. He's the master of taekwondo. The kicking karate from Korea, and I mastered everything. We don't make no plan. We just do what we're going to do.
Would you like to say goodbye to the audience?
You don't say nothing. I say everything. What's the matter with you? I am captain, and me, when I speak it for me and Tiger Charlie. You understand me? Banzai!
We'll be right back.
We'll make a great team, old man. You for the words, me for the pictures. I can be your eyes.
An ambitious journalist on his first assignment overseas and a British military attaché find themselves thrown together by circumstances in Indonesia.
A ship left Shanghai a few days ago with arms for the PKR.
Civil war.
Look, I'm not telling you this to give you some fantastic scoop. I just want you to save your life.
Billy, I can't let a story like that just lie.
I created you.
Mel Gibson, Sigourney Weaver, The Year of Living Dangerously.
Gentlemen, the Institute's code of honor is a simple one. A cadet will not lie, cheat, steal, tolerate those who do. A simple code, but it is a stern code.
Would you or any other
gentleman care to partake?
Have any food off my plate, sir?
The Institute does not forgive.
Look up!
Poutine, get down from here.
They won't let me.
Poutine, there's nobody up here.
If I face the 10, I'm going on a ride.
Bear, what's the 10?
Help!
They used to say that it was a legend. Like ghosts and avenging angels.
Fatigue?
I hate it. I loathe deliberate cruelty.
Who did this to you?
It was dark. Then they took off my blindfold.
And he said...
He spoke?
They said you're going on the ride.
You'll be going down to home. Even if you come out alive, you wish you was dead.
How many of them were there?
10.
Worn the ring.
The Lords of Discipline.
Well, Gorilla Monsoon, while things are reasonably quiet, a little bit of a temporary lull. Any comments?
Well, unbelievable matches so far. Dick, I just want to interject another little idea here for Simon Whitfield. They're going to have a special benefit dinner for Simon. It'll be held on Wednesday, March 7th, from 7 to 12 midnight at the Marion Caters, Route 130 in Cinnaminson. And like to see a lot of wrestling fans down there, because this is for a very worthy cause, and Simon's a super guy.
Well, I'm sure they'll support him. Well, the match coming up now.
The Mideast Connection.
You bet. And a super-duper connection coming along here, the likes of Eddie Gilbert and one very popular Tony Correa.
Boy, Santana didn't waste any time, Dick. He picked right up where they left off last month here in the Spectrum, in that rhubarb that he and the Sheik had, and they still didn't get it settled.
No, no. They got to come back again.
Let's go up to our ring announcer. If we can wake him up, we'll get to him.
Ladies and gentlemen, this next contest is also a tag team attraction, scheduled for one fall with a 30-minute time limit. Introducing first, in the corner to my left, the tag team combination that consists of, first, from Osaka, Japan, weighing 248 pounds, the martial arts expert, Mr. Fuji. And ladies and gentlemen, his tag team partner from Seoul, Korea, weighing 270 pounds, Tiger Chung Lee. Their opponents are from Lexington, Tennessee, weighing 225 pounds, the fiery Eddie Gilbert. And his tag team partner from Auckland, New Zealand, weighing 242 pounds, Tony Garea.
Well, you've got a contrast, fans. The two Oriental gentlemen at one extreme, and Garea and Gilbert at the other. Two hated, the other two beloved by all wrestling fans. So you go from one end of the spectrum, literally, to the other.
Well, you got speed and agility on the side of Garea and young Eddie Gilbert, and you've got devastating power, cunning, and martial arts on the other side. And Mr. Fuji is someone to be reckoned with.
Well, the interview that Cal Rudman put together with Fuji and Tiger Chung Lee clearly explained where they're coming from tonight. Interesting comments by Mr. Fuji, who is sort of the spokesman. Interestingly enough, across the ring there was some sort of a yellow placard held by some fan with some Oriental words on it. I don't know, understand something, Mr. Fuji, something or other. Oh, there we go. There's the sign up again. Now it's down. But anyway, I don't know what it's bad words or what, but
I guess only the person that made it, and maybe Mr. Fuji knows what it says.
Maybe he doesn't want to know. Fuji, with his arm hand behind him,
he's still got 42 pounds of salt left in that right hand.
Sure does.
From the Oriental salt ceremony, shaking, chasing the evil spirits.
Dick Worley checking the hands, Mr. Fuji, but he quickly put the pack of salt under his armpit. Now it's back in his right hand again. Worley says, give it to me. Eddie Gilbert trying to point out where it might be.
Where is it? In the tights?
Yeah.
Yep, stuck it up on him.
He's clever.
He's a master.
There's that sign on the other side of Fuji. Came up very briefly. We'll make a project out of it, but it's interesting, the Oriental wording there, whatever it means. Okay. Eddie Gilbert to tear off against Mr. Fuji.
Super duper.
Oh! He found it. All right. Dick Worley. All right. He found the package of salt. The salt dumped over the side of the ring, and the fans really responded. Eddie Gilbert now pounding on Mr. Fuji. Bring him our way against the ropes. Oh, a chop to the midsection. That body drop. Eddie Gilbert from a very illustrious wrestling family. He's right on top of it. And picks him up again. Body drop. Body slam. Eddie Gilbert's ready. He's just fiery for sure. Shakes up the lower back. There's a drop kick. Now the tag. Tiger Chung Lee coming in. Arm drag takedown by Gilbert. Another one. Woo! The action's going fast and furious here.
Eddie Gilbert, a house of fire, now gets shoved in by the Tiger. Shoulder block sends a big guy down, but look out. Who knows what's going to happen? Nicely frog.
Whoa!
Drop kick.
But he hurt himself. Gilbert. Somehow, watching Chung Lee's response to the drop kick, but Gilbert went down.
Might have pulled a hamstring.
He might. He's favoring the inside of one leg. I think the right, maybe. Or maybe it's the back. He looked like he's holding his leg. Yeah, the
get
back.
Get right over there and tag Eddie. Oh,
there's Korea.
Holy mackerel. Woo!
Whoa! Korea really taking off after him. And nice shot. Comes down with a kick to the upper shoulder.
Korea hesitating to put that boot between the eyes of Tiger Chung Lee. Why? I don't know. I'm sure the Tiger wouldn't hesitate a moment.
Well, he's sort of settled down here. Got off to a really fast start. And nevertheless, Korea off the ropes. Shoulder block. Down goes Lee. Oh, nice maneuver.
Reverse hip lock.
Arm drag by Gurria. He's in control, at least right now. Pulls that knee down, smashing all his weight in the shoulder area of Tiger Chung Lee. Tag made, Eddie Gilbert back in again. Coming off the ropes, huh? Oh, shoulder. Or rather, an elbow smash. Another elbow smash.
Seems to be all right there.
He might have
just pinched something in there momentarily. That little breather was enough to straighten out whatever he did, because he seems to be fine right now.
Seems to be. All right, Gurria coming off the rope cutter.
No, he's still over there in the corner, Dick. Take a look at Eddie.
Yeah.
Something's bothering him back there.
Yeah. He's stretching a little bit, trying to get iron out the kinks, I guess.
Chunger trying to make it back to the corner to tag young Eddie in. That's going to bring Fuji in, I'm sure, and it doesn't.
All right, coming our way. Shoulder block by Gurria. Down goes Chung Lee.
Oh, Fuji caught him with a karate kick right to the back of the neck.
Fuji caught him for sure. Gurria wasn't ready for that. Why would he be? Wasn't expecting it. Down he goes. The tag made. Chung Lee off, going out. And Fuji in.
Ooh. Fuji, big karate thrust right to the lower abdomen area. This is when Fuji's most dangerous. When he's got you in a compromising position and can really level you.
Well, he's doing it to him, I tell you. Fuji really toying with him now. Yeah, brings that headbutt down.
Right down into the sternum.
Gurria really in bad shape. And I'll tell you, fans, he must be about 8 to 10 feet away from Eddie Gilbert. Don't look for a tag right now. No way. And between the two of them is Fuji. Fuji giving a shot to the head, Eddie Gilbert. Down goes Gilbert outside the ring. Meanwhile, Gurria shaking his head. Went back in, distracting referee Dick Worley. Fuji, meanwhile, waves in Tiger Chung Lee.
Big mistake on the part of young Eddie Gilbert.
And no tag either. The fans saw it. Fuji out, Lee in, but no tag given.
Affording the Orientals another choice opportunity to take advantage of the back-turned referee.
But sure,
here he comes again. You're going to get another switch.
Back to him.
Double team effort before the switch.
Find the pressure to Tony Gurria. Tony's been here before with that kind of pressure on him. All right, you talk about Gilbert. What a teammate he is. Bang on the rim, apron. Trying to get Gurria. Charge him up. He's a competitor, that Eddie Gilbert. Helping his guy on his feet. Gurria on his feet now. Shoulder block.
Nicely frog.
Oh,
watch up! Oh, but he just missed the knee.
Fuji, quick as you can make it, really fast.
Brought his knee up, and down goes Correa. Fuji is just reveling in this, just really loving it. Correa once again in trouble as the tag made as the Tiger Chung Lee steps in.
Well, legitimate tag this time. The tag was in fact made. Worley in plain view couldn't see it. The tag before was not a tag. All right, Chung Lee still guarding for the midsection of Tony Correa. And Eddie Gilbert helpless. Tag team partner on the outside of the rope.
Karate chop right to the top of the head.
Correa, really. I don't know what's holding him up.
Correa sneaks through the legs and makes a tag. Gilbert in a house of fire and he's throwing big right hands.
Oh, he gives Fuji a shot. Comes after Tiger Lee. Going after the midsection. Going for the head. Take him into the corner.
A steel post.
And his shoulder collided with that steel post, and the post itself is about 4 inches thick. 4 inches wide, rather, in diameter. Woo! Eddie Gilbert hanging by a thread.
What a mistake. That could be the beginning of the end.
Might be. Here comes, what, body slam?
High body slam. Look out. Banzai coming up. Eddie Gilbert rolls out of the way just in time. His head.
He came down and nobody was home. Fuji came down with a head leading and Eddie Gilbert rolled away. Gilbert now maybe has turned the tide, but he's still stunned. Tiger Chung Lee ministering to Mr. Fuji.
Chung Lee is not the legal man in the ring. I don't understand how Dick Willie can let this go on.
Well, they touched. I don't think that was a tag, though. Dick Worley warning Chung Lee about something.
Fuji's still laying down there.
Fuji must be out.
Eddie looking for the right corner to go to make the tag.
And there's a look at Fuji. All right. He's down and out. There's the tag.
Tag made.
Really on a tear. Hart brings the knee up again. Again. Going after Chung Lee.
Nice drop kick by Correa. And a high cross body's got him down there. One, two. Almost.
Two and a half maybe. Close. But no cigar. Go after him. Now he's after the head again. Going after the head.
Small package.
Two. Oh, close. Bunny had him. So did Correa.
Sunset right, flip. Flip.
Broken again. Correa's got
and Fuji still laying prone on the ring apron.
He is out. Correa's got to wonder. He's got to take a... Correa's got to wonder.
Fuji got to still down and out. Surprised he hasn't been knocked right off that apron by now, but he's still laying there. Correa having all kinds of problems trying to get a three count on the big guy.
Woo! The tag made.
Big back
Gilbert
in.
Back body drop. Gilbert just tagged by Correa. Oh!
Gilbert going for abdominal stretch. He's got it on there.
Lee trying to go for the hair.
He doesn't have the leverage he needs, though, unfortunately. Comes in and stops on him. Look at Fuji reaching in his tights. Coming up with something. Who knows what? It's more salt. Right in the face of Eddie Gilbert. I can't believe it. Gilbert is behind in play. Gilbert blinded by the salt from Mr. Fuji.
Fuji
referee did not see it.
Fuji unleashed. He went into his tights. Laid a pack of salt in the eyes I mean just about all of the salt in the eyes of one Danny Gilbert, who responded immediately. Have you ever had salt in your eyes? You know, or soap. Oh, Gurria, really. I mean, Gurria, he didn't want to go after the two Orientals or stay in with Eddie Gilbert. You talk about upset.
That could develop into a permanent eye injury. Very, very dangerous.
Well, let's get the official time.
The time of the fall, 11 minutes, 47 seconds. The winners of this contest, the team of Mr. Fuji and Tiger Chuck.
Extremely unpopular decision, and rightly so, as Mr. Fuji, who we thought was down and out of it, comes up with another 5 pounds of salt. Let's take a look at it. Here it is. Fuji, look at him now, sneaking along, reaching down into his tights. He knows he's got some more salt down there. Here it comes out, opens up the bundle. Young Eddie Gilbert now thought he could get a submission here. Look at this, right in a kisser, right in the eyes, blinds him. Referee Dick Worley did not see it. He was putting out Tony Gurria. Junger goes down, makes the cover. Nothing Eddie can do. He counted him right out.
Fans, and Dick Worley is using some of his shirt to minister the eyes of Eddie Gilbert. Well, fans, Prism has all your favorite local teams, the Flyers, the Sixers, boxing, wrestling, and Big Five. Here's what's coming up.
An old rivalry will be renewed this Thursday at the Spectrum and on Prism as Brian Bellows and the Minnesota North Stars face Bobby Clark, Bill Barber, and the Philadelphia Flyers. The North Stars battle the Flyers Thursday at 7:30, a Prism exclusive. The Streamers will be flying at the Palestra this Saturday afternoon as Steve Black and LaSalle face Granger Hall and Temple. The Explorers and the Owls in Big Five action Saturday afternoon at 3, a Prism exclusive.
The story of Art Long, an ordinary man who led an average life.
You've never made a dime at your music. Into some sort of damn hobby.
Just a regular guy trying to make ends meet.
I think I found a way to pay the bills that I can live with.
You beat up a guy, and if you win, you win $5,000.
Poor guy. I won in Fort Worth. I go to Detroit, I fight for $100,000, and maybe the chance to go on to become Miss Universe.
I want you to know exactly who you're fighting and what the hell you're getting into.
I know what I'm getting into. I'm fighting rapists and axe murderers.
Please don't fight again.
You gotta see this through.
You can't beat Truman Wall. He's a killer.
Tough enough.
Cal Rudman here, backstage at the Spectrum. In just about a few minutes, we're going to have a match pitting the irresistible force against the immovable object. Well, I guess I know who this is. You are blocking the view from my millions of music fans. Hulkamania, Hulk Hogan.
You know something, Killer Cal? It's been a long time, little dude, since I've seen you. And you know something? You're still dressing good and looking fine. Let me tell you, Philadelphia man, I got goosebumps up and down my body because the Hulkster is here. And I got something to say. You see, it's been a little while. My man Cal ain't seen the Hulkster. But Killer Cal, as soon as you see the Hulkster walk out in the center of the ring, something's going to happen to you, dude.
What's going to happen to me? Goosebumps? Goosebumps.
Hulkamania. You're going to take one hit of the air out there. It's the ultimate natural high, Daddy, because when I hit the ring, there's going to be so much electricity, more electricity than when I took Rocky Balboa and pressed him over my head and threw him out in Philadelphia's own Liberty Bell City. But the thing is, I come into town a couple days early to do some hanging and banging, Daddy, to train the 24th Pythons, which are a little bit bigger than your head, dude. And the thing is, double by, double try, hanging and banging. T-bone steaks and dumbbell plates. Wait a minute, you're getting me off the subject. The thing I was talking about, man, you're getting me pumped already. I was in town a couple days early, and everywhere I went, people were saying, Hulkster, you've been gone so long, man, we're happy to see you, and we're glad. that you're the WWF champion, because now we got somebody that we can stand behind, and now we got somebody that is a fighting champion, and I will not hide behind a manager or any wrestling alliance.
Do you plan to pull the mask off the masked superstar to humiliate him in addition to beating him and defending your championship?
Well, the thing is, Killer Cal, I got nothing personal against the man. But the holster is bad to the bone. And the thing is, I'm going out there with one thing in mind: to remain the WWF champion. And the thing is, I'm going to beat the man. Yes, I am, because Hulkamania is going to be running wild. But if the man takes a few shortcuts, if he tries to do a few dirty tricks to the holster, I just might go ahead and jerk that mask off his ugly head.
I want everybody to know that in spite of the stentorian the stentorian tones that you hear, Hulk Hogan really is personally a nice guy. I was trying to get him to talk in a calm voice.
Man, I am calm. You ought to hear me. When I'm wired up, Daddy, I'm like thunder and lightning in a wide open field. But the thing is, the Hulkster is one heck of a nice guy, Daddy. I mean, I am the All-American. I train, I say my prayers, I eat my vitamins every day, Daddy. And that's what I get going for me. I'm on a roll. I'm doing everything right. And I get the whole WWF, the whole United States of America behind me, the Purple Mountains, Majesty, everything.
I can understand it. But I spoke to the masked superstar, and he said, you got it, and he wants it. Everything he's ever dreamed about it. And he intends to wipe the place out with you tonight.
Well, the thing is, little dude, the thing is, the life I'm living is reality, brother. I've trained all my life for it. The life the superstar wants is nothing but a dream. There is no way, Daddy, on this face of the earth, the superstar is going to put the holster down with thousands and thousands and thousands of Philadelphia Knights standing behind me.
You heard it.
You better be at ringside. You better be watching in my corner, because Hulkamania is going to get you, and this is Python power. Hulkamania is running wild.
I'll be sitting on the front row. Throw the superstar right into my lap. We'll be right back.
Flashdance is music. Flashdance is dancing. Flashdance is friendship and love. Flashdance. She's a maniac, maniac,
I never had any feelings like this toward Dr. Jaffe. I never had any fantasies.
Are you having one now?
When falling in love is the last thing you need, why is it always the first thing you do?
I've fallen in love with a patient.
I see that you are flushing a brilliant career down the toilet.
Read about that moron, California. Have sex with a patient. They awarded her $3 million.
They put a very high value on sex in California.
I swear to you, Saul Benjamin is a prudent, sober physician.
Did I take all my clothes off at any point during the ravioli?
Tell me, did they have sexual relations on the couch?
Oh, boy.
You are getting an anxiety attack.
No, I don't.
You are.
I don't get anxiety attacks.
This seems to be the trouble.
I can't treat you anymore.
What?
I'm in love with you.
Dudley Moore, Elizabeth McGovern, lovesick.
Ringside, Gorilla Monsoon, this is Dick Graham. You got a picture of the tunnel, and look who's coming right at you.
The masked superstar.
The masked superstar for real. And the crowd starts to crank up again. And of course, waiting in the wings to shortly make his appearance here for the first time as champion, Hulkamania is about to set in. We'll get that on in just a moment. So I'm telling you, the fans are getting more of their money's worth at the Spectrum, as they always do. Some of the people ringside are wearing paper bags on their heads with appropriate remarks geared toward the masked superstar.
There's the music, Dick. The Eye of the Tiger could mean only one thing.
And the fans picked it up. They're on their feet in unison here at the jam-packed Spectrum as the incredible one, Hulk Hogan, is going to make his debut here as the new World Wrestling Federation heavyweight champion. Well, he must be on his way. We can't see him yet.
There he is.
Comes.
Superstar.
Tough title defense for the Hulk.
Crank it up. Hogan, I checked him out earlier tonight, said hi to him. His weight about 295. Oh!
Irresistible force meeting the superstar doesn't like it.
Don't you really love it to death?
Like the immovable mountain standing there. And you think a guy like the Smash Superstar doesn't have some thinking to do? He's wondering, where do I go from here?
Boy, Hulk's career and reputation has really skyrocketed since Rocky III. He was well on his way at that point.
You bet.
And Rocky III just put him over the top, and he has been phenomenal since. Hence, Hulkamania is here to stay.
Well, I'll tell you, talking to Howard Eskin from Channel 3 up in the press box a little while ago, he's here tonight. Clark DeLeon from the Philadelphia Inquirer, he's here tonight. I'm telling you, man, Hulkamania has set in. Good to see Howard here tonight. Howard Eskin from WKYW, Channel 3.
Test the strength here. Both men, powerhouses.
This could go either way. Either man could dominate. The thing is, with Hogan, there's so much of him. He has the superstar on his toes. Now on his knees.
Superstar bails out looking for higher or lower ground, however you want to call it.
Talk about a man who is in control. It's the man from California. Woo! He's a trip. Talking to him earlier tonight, he is a trip.
In fantastic condition, as is obvious.
Really. Well, the superstar thinking carefully, slowly about coming back in the ring. He's not in a great hurry. All right, back in. Hogan waiting. Hogan, though, may seem at times a little frivolous, but he knows he's the champion. There's a lot to lose, so he's not taking this guy lightly, for sure. Side headlock. Superstar on the super champ.
Oh, you can't take anybody lightly when you're the champion and you step in there and that referee takes your belt and gives it to the timekeeper or the state athletic commission, whatever you may have.
Anybody's belt.
You better have it all together.
All right.
Mass superstar dishing out some heavy punishment now as the Hulk goes down to the canvas.
Well, the ringside is yelling, Hulk, Hulk, Hulk. Double karate chop. Another smash the back of the head. Yes! Woo-hoo! The joint is jumping. I mean, don't you love it? Hulk is taking off.
And under the bottom rope slides the Masked Superstar, and he was hurt with that shot.
Coming after him.
Hulk right out after him.
Hulk watches. Woo! He can do no wrong.
Look out, atomic drop outside. He ran right into the post.
Superstar may be ready to turn in his mask after tonight.
Could very possibly see that mask come off here tonight.
Maybe. Woo. I'm telling you, I haven't seen such excitement here at the Spectrum in early. I can't tell you how long, but I've seen a lot of exciting nights and events, matches. Get the mask, get the mask. Maybe that's on Hulk Hogan's mind, too.
The mask! Get the mask!
Well, that would be the ultimate humiliation.
Get the mask!
off. He's in business.
Pushing that arm. Get that arm ringer going strong. Whoa. Oh,
what a head to the
midsection. Right into that headbutt, right into the sternum, and almost knocked the wind out of him. Hulk down there sucking for some air right now.
He really is.
One, down for the cover.
Whoa, kicked out.
He threw him off of there like a rag doll, man.
He was close. He knew he was close to the end. A chop to the throat of Hulk Hogan. He's in trouble. Kick to the head. Further trouble. Another kick. The Hulk down. Past superstar pounding away on him.
Reverse chin lock now. Referee down there checking for a choke.
Hey, the Hawker. The Hawker holds one finger up saying, hey, I'm down but not out, gang. Don't go away. The Hulk is on a tear.
Oh, it ran right into that big knee. Very clever maneuver on the part of the mask. One, two. Down the cover.
Kicks out a little bit. Wasn't much steam there.
Beautiful shot by one of our number five handheld cameras.
Beautiful job. There you can see the trouble that Hulk Hogan is in currently. Joey Morella holding up the arm of Hulk Hogan once to see whether there's anything going on. And the fans here trying to charge up Hogan. Whoa! On one knee. Trying to get it on. On both feet. Trying to break the hold. Hogan still trying to get it on. Breaks the hold. Now taking the mass superstar to the ropes.
Oh, he missed a big elbow.
Oh!
Beautiful flying headbutt on the part of the mass superstar. Two.
Superstar getting a little frustrated here. He's tired right now, seems to be. He's taking a beating. Got to get that strength back from somewhere. Still maintaining front face lock and a sense on past superstar.
He picked him up like a rag doll and drives him into the turnbuckles in the corner of the ring. And that took its toll on the mass superstar as he is down.
This might be the bidding of the end. I don't know.
Woo! Oh, big clothesline.
He caught him.
One of Hulk's favorite moves, down for the cover. Yes. No, he's got his foot on the rope.
Foot on the rope. You got to break it.
Take it fast, Bob.
Uh-oh. Superstar reached into his tight stick.
I don't know what he has.
He reached in there. I don't know if he has anything, but I know he reached in there.
He's got something.
Oh, he nailed the Hulk right in the throat.
He's got something in the fist. I don't know what it is. And
he's got something in his hand.
There's a shot to the side of the head by the superstar on Hogan.
Got to have something in that hand. That was too devastating a blow just for a natural.
Oh! I don't know. Kick at the head of Hulk Hogan. Oh!
He dropped it, whatever it was.
Something there. Hey, ring of the bell.
Hulk's got it.
Apparently, it's all over.
Might be a disqualification. action here. Referee Joe Morello saw that pop right out of his hand. Hulk's not satisfied. He's going after him.
Pull it back in.
Superstar trying to get out of there. The Hulk is going to work on the hood.
Woo! Hey, yo!
Oh, he's going to take it off. He made the gesture. Fans want to see it. Bails out underneath. Hulk right out the side going after him. He wants to take that mask off. He's right behind him. He bails out and he's still pulling at it.
He's coming our way.
He's throwing him back into the ring. And right out the other side goes the masked superstar.
Decision.
I'm sure it was a disqualification, but let's go up and get it.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 10 minutes, 43 seconds, the referee has disqualified the masked superstar.
The fans here in a jam-packed Spectrum on their feet. The World Wrestling Federation champion retaining his title in an unbelievable confrontation.
Well, confrontation and then some, more like an all-out war. But I'll tell you, he did it. Let's check it out again. As Hulk Hogan goes off. Here's some replay for you. Smash to the head on Hogan.
Hogan went down heavy there, Dick. It was not a normal blow. It had to be obvious that he had something in his hand. Going to work now on the Hulk, planting those big size 15s right in the side of the face, and that has to hurt. Well, now look at this. There it went in the air. We saw it fly out of there. Referee Joe Morella right on top of the situation.
Whatever had happened there, he went for that foreign object, whatever. Hogan went after it, too. Tell you. All right. Well, fans, coming up next, Salvatore Palomo battled Butcher Paul Vachon. We'll be right back.
Gary Cooper and David Bivens are caught in an uprising in the Philippines in The Real Glory. A young man from the slums who's using his talent to lash out at the authorities in the loneliness of a long-distance runner. Danny Kaye as a milkman who accidentally becomes the world's middleweight champ in The Kid from Brooklyn. And Edward G. Robinson as a businessman whose shady doings could destroy him and his family in Arthur Miller's All My Sons. Classics, the way they were meant to be seen, uncut and uninterrupted. Watch for them in February.
For the 1957 Pennsylvania High School Basketball Champion.
Hear, hear.
Five men get together each year to relive the glory days.
You were one flesh 24 years ago, boys. Don't you forget that as long as you live.
But a lot has happened over the years, and this reunion could be their last.
What is nice about betrayal, I ask you? Because that's what we're talking about, George. Betrayal, nothing less. Right, Phil?
Yeah, go away, James.
Because we're friends here,
right?
Yes. You think he's your friend?
Yes, I do.
Well, then you are really stupid.
You boys are my real trophies. Never forget that. Never.
Robert Mitchum, Martin Sheen, Bruce Dern, Stacy Keach, and Paul Sorvino. That championship season.
This is Dick Graham with Gorilla Monsoon at the Spectrum. And now let's learn what's next.
Wrestling fans, this next event is a one-fall contest with a 20-minute time limit. Introducing first from Montreal, Canada, weighing 282 pounds, the Montreal Express, Butcher Paul Vachon. His opponent, Italy, weighing 237 pounds, Salvatore Bellomo.
Well, all out booze. Whoa! What happens here? Underway without any prior warning. There's the bell now. And already it started. Rashad taking off after Bellomo. Bellomo stunned. Smashed into the turnbuckle. Down on one knee. And Rashad is on a tear. Tearing at the back of Bellomo. Going for the eyes of Bellomo. Going for the eyes again of Bellomo. The midsection. Woo! Rashad must have a plane to catch. Going after Bellomo in the far corner.
Boyd really going to work on him right off the bat. No hesitation whatsoever.
He wants to get it over with fast.
Bellomo off the top turnbuckle. Nobody there off the second turnbuckle.
Jarred is back on that one. Bellomo coming off the ropes. We've seen him do that time and time again successfully.
Rashad still pounding on him.
Pounding him down to the... Well, he's back up again.
Reverse. Reverse neck breaker here. The hangman, it's called. Bellomo right up over the top. Beautiful maneuver into a small package. He could get him here. He got him.
He did. Woo. All right. You talked about fast. Here I thought Deshaun wanted to get it over with fast. But Bellomo did a tap dance in his head. Bellomo is excelling.
Tables turned in a hurry. Let's get the official time.
Ladies and gentlemen, the time of the fall, 1:09. Your winner, Salvatore Bellomo.
Deshaun, so disgusted with himself, maybe, or the decision, or both. He didn't waste it. He's gone. He took off. He couldn't take it. Very disturbed. I think he's a lot very disturbed with himself. He had some action going for himself.
Well, he didn't make a mistake. Look, he went for this beautiful hangman here, reverse neck breaker. Salvatore just kips right up. Beautiful maneuver. Slides right over to that small package.
Pull the leg up. Got him. Nailed him.
Got the big three.
Zaffirino. Whoa, fans.
Gentlemen, the date of the next All-Star card of wrestling slated for the Philadelphia Spectrum will be Saturday evening, March 31st. Slated for Saturday evening, March 31st, victorious in the ring just a short while ago will be Salvatore Bellomo. His opponent, Rene Goulet. Saturday, March Saturday, March 31st, will be for the World Tag Team Championship title. As the current title holders, the sensational Rocky Johnson and Mr. USA Tony Atlas will place their title on the line against the Oriental Connection of Mr. Fuji and his tag team partner, Tiger Chung Lee. And ladies and gentlemen, also on Saturday evening, March 31st, return appearance here in this arena after a lengthy absence will be the master of the figure four leg lock, ladies and gentlemen, Greg the Hammer Valentine, as he faces the Intercontinental Heavyweight Champion, Tito Santana. Defense, and this is for the World Wrestling Federation Heavyweight Championship. And in that contest, the current title holder, the fabulous Hulk Hogan, steps into the ring with the former World Wrestling Federation Champion, Tehran Iran's The Iron. Attraction Saturday evening, March 31st, a special six-man tag team event is scheduled to take place. On the one side, Afa, Sika, Samu, the Wild Samoans 1, 2, and 3 will face one-on-one against Tony Garea, Jimmy Superfly Snuka, and his tag team partner, the eighth wonder of the world, Andre the Giant.
Wow. You talk about a heavy lineup, Gorilla Monsoon. That's that. That is a heavy lineup, and then some, I tell you.
We've got at least four or five main events there, Dick.
Crazy.
Six-man tag is a main event in itself. Hulk Hogan putting his title on against the former champion, the Iron Sheik. Atlas and Johnson putting their title up against Fuji and Lee, who were victorious here tonight. A girls' tag team championship. Mr. Wonderful appearing against Chief J. Strongbow. Holy mackerel, what a fantastic card.
March 31st, Saturday night, and fans will be here, and I'm sure you will. I mean, don't you love it? Tell you, we're going to go with a tag team as the windup, if your heart can take it. I'm running out of gas, fans. I don't know about you. Whew, I've had excitement and then some tonight.
Well, we're waiting for the roof to come off. We're waiting for Andre and the Superfly to make their way down here.
Well, the World Wrestling Federation is the home of the stars, the wrestling stars. And you mentioned Andre, and he's certainly one of them.
Holy mackerel, this is the Mecca, Dick. This is where they all want to come. This is where the greatest professional wrestling congregate. They know that this is where all the titles are at stake. The greatest wrestling fans in the world here in the World Wrestling Federation. And here they come.
Woo-hoo! Here comes Andre, and the fans are loving it. And I mean, don't you love it, the Death Fans? Don't you really love it? Look who's first.
first, the Superfly, Andre. Woo-hoo.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the final contest, scheduled for one fall with a 30-minute time limit. It is a tag team attraction. Introducing first in the corner to my right, first from Nashville, Tennessee, weighing 268 pounds, making his first appearance at the Philadelphia Spectrum, Dr. D. David Schultz.
Sergeant Slaughter. Talk about that later.
Wrestling fans, they will wrestle first from the Fiji Islands, weighing 250 pounds, the Phenom, Jimmy Superfly Snuka. And his tag team partner from Grenoble in the French Alps, weighing 486 pounds, the eighth wonder of the world, Andre the Giant.
Well, you heard it, the introductions. Oh, it's gone. Woo-hoo! Action started already.
Wow.
Ring announcer just about out of the ring, and we're underway. And they're both. John Morella, the referee, going to stand back. Andre to the headbutt of Dr. D. Superfly Snuka going at it in the ring with Sergeant Slaughter.
Jimmy in the wrong corner right now.
He is, and Dr. D takes the tag from Sergeant Slaughter to make the tag again. Back comes Slaughter. Smash to the rib section. Smash to the back of the head. Tag again. Here comes Dr. D. Hey, they're working on Snuka for sure.
Jimmy retaliated with a few right hands, but the doctor's still on top of him. Rough customer, this Dr. Schultz.
He really is.
Another quick tag.
Kicking Snuka in the midsection to the ribs. Crashing the forearm down the back of the head. He's in bad trouble. The wrong corner for sure.
Oh, he nails Schultz. Slaughter nails Schultz. And Slaughter goes down. Jimmy hooks him. Almost got a three count.
Oh.
Nice maneuver on the part of Jimmy.
Slaughter. Slaughter. Just barely got out of that one. One, two. Kicks out. He has a leg pull up. He wanted to make the tag and nobody home.
Schultz don't want a tag. He turned his back on him.
Schultz
turned his back on the sergeant.
Schultz got back on the ring apron after he
walked away.
He says, forget it, man. Coming our way.
Woo! Down for the cover again.
Schultz says, come on.
He still don't want to tag.
He still
can't
upset.
Believe it.
And you know the fans are on him because they don't like to see one partner hanging the other out to dry, even though they don't like.
Oh, the big guy's in there and drops the sergeant with a big chop. Look out! Big headbutt sends Sarge down, and he's still looking to tag, and Schultz giving him the shoulder one.
Place to go.
Slaughter has no partner. This is a handicap match.
Well, it's outside the ring, actually. And Schultz waving him back in says, I don't like parts of you, Slaughter.
Reaching up now. Look at that. He made a tag. What is back
was turned to Sarge, reached over and tagged. Schultz doesn't like it.
He says, no, he never tagged me, man, much to somebody else.
Referee says you did tag.
Slaughter wants... Slaughter needs time.
Oh, Schultz nails Slaughter. Look out. Oh, Sarge doesn't take that from anybody. Schultz bailing out. Sarge right after him.
Crack and sweat now.
Referee counting him. He counted him out. Schultz coming in the ring now. Uh-oh. In the wrong place. No place for him to go. Schultz heading for higher ground and Sarge right on his behind.
And he's still
and he nails him halfway back to the dressing room.
You love it, fans. Really?
Slaughter is hot.
Slaughter coming in now. He wants it, everybody. He's not even ticked off so much at Snuka and Andre. He's more angry at Schultz.
That's a mistake.
He's got to give it to somebody. Morella better try. The young guy, Joey Morella, better try to talk him out of it.
I don't see a ring announcer in sight here. Sergeant Slaughter, look at the Sarge, look at that hand. And Jimmy too, giving the I love you
all
sign
right.
To the Sarge.
And the fans are standing
fans
there.
Are under there.
Woo-hoo.
Yeah. I love it.
Fans, don't you really love to death what you see here tonight.
All right, Jimmy Superfly Snuka.
All right.
And Andre the Giant shaking hands with Sergeant Slaughter, giving the peace sign, the I love you sign.
The Slaughter
and the Sarge and the fans love it.
All right. Well, the fans are loving it. And I know you are wherever you're watching.
Ring announcer not in sight, but we don't need him. We know that this isn't here. Andre the Giant and Superfly victorious on a count out. Sergeant Slaughter here in the Spectrum tonight became the greatest thing since sliced bread. The fans love him.
Well, you're seeing it all tonight, fans.
Unbelievable night of wrestling here at the Spectrum. Jam pack. Sergeant Slaughter still in the ring. Fans still on their feet. What a night of wrestling.
Slaughter wants to say something. Let's pick it up. Let's pick it up.
Sergeant Slaughter said, get the Sheik out here right now.
Well, he won himself a bundle of fans on that one.
Highly unlikely he's not in the building. A fantastic night of wrestling from the Spectrum.
Hey, March 31st, be here. Gorilla Monsoon, Dick Graham, good to see you later.
You're watching Prism, the best in sports, movies, and entertainment specials.
It's the excitement of the World Wrestling Federation, and it's coming up next. So settle in and get comfortable for the next 2.5 hours as Prism presents Spectrum Wrestling.